All right. So in the updates of the day, like, oh my gosh, the day. I know I'm talking still funny because of my, what do we call it, the tooth thing. But we have not the fairy, not the tooth fairy. Oh gosh, no, it Thanksgiving. Now, Thanksgiving went well. There was how shall I say it? Football. I did see football there. And what else? My goodness, there was a musical moment with an instrument. That's always entertaining. And what else? Yeah, I like the entertaining with the music. Oh my gosh, vegan. Yeah, it was vegan enough for me, so I survived that. My gosh. Pies and cakes. Oh my gosh. It was like being in a pie and cake shop. So way huge amount of pies and cakes. We're talking chocolate cake, we're talking pecan pie, we're talking a caramel cream whipped pie. We're talking also a lemon meringue. A lemon meringue. Now that one really is like, whoa, that's a rarity. It's a rarity. So we had a lemon meringue that was amazing. And did I miss something? There seems to be one that's missing. I know there was another one. But yeah, oh my gosh, pies and cakes and pies and cakes and pies and cakes. Yeah, and handmade, all of them. Pretty much so. I think so, everyone. So congratulations to the bakers, the bakers of, 'cause my gosh, I mean, from scratch making the crust and everything. So good for you for that. And my gosh, what else? No cherry pie this Thanksgiving, and I know that that's one of my brother's favorites. I have one brother that just adores cherry pie, and so he didn't get cherry pie in my Thanksgiving moment here, so sorry about that. I can't relay a cherry pie if you're watching this through the lines to you. I can't say, oh, I saw a cherry pie, or I ate a little bit of cherry pie, so I can't give that back. So we're short one cherry pie, and so that's what happened. I joined a Reiki group, so I'm kind of excited for it. It's one of these meetup places. Gosh dang it, it's yoga, so it's for gurus. It's for us to get all yogi with, and so I'm very, very happy about it. And gosh dang it, I hope it doesn't cost any money, but perhaps I'll make some friends through there. And what else? Oh, I met like a a chemical physicist woman. Going to school, and very much likely she will be designing flowers in the future. You know what I mean? Like actually making different beautiful flowers, like painting them different colors. It's in a way, I don't know. Sometimes science is kind of interesting what it can do. So we can make beautiful flowers. What else? Oh my gosh, that's enough, isn't it? Yeah, it was just a thanks. It was a happy vegan Thanksgiving to everyone. And so I met a few interesting people, and that's about that. It was a brief a brevity. So I feel like I'm being luxuriated in all of this food and feast, and yet I don't know. I'm gonna focus now on yoga. Maybe yoga. Maybe back to Reiki and back to back to body, all of this, business. I get back to the body business, maybe. Maybe there's some help for me there with that group. Yeah, there's 292 of you, I think I read. I think that's what it says here. And so I'm kind of excited. Yeah, 292. And one of those is me. So before it was 291, which is odd, and now I'm here, so we're even. Unless, I don't know, unless I'm the 293. No, because I didn't log out yet. So that would make it odd again. So I don't know. I'm not trying to chase that tale of odd and even and numerology, but it does exist, doesn't it? Yeah, numerology does want to exist in our minds and go, oh, I see that, or I see that other, and we try to chase it, try to chase that number game. There's a seven again. I'm seeing a seven. What is the significance? And then you search it back and go, well, it's the G. It stands for G, and then G stands for, am I missing a person in my life with that name? You know what I mean? Am I missing a person? Am I missing, or is this something governmental? The government is after me, and it's like a secret code that they're sending me into my brain. Or there's just a reminder, pay your income tax or something. You know what I'm saying? A lot of sevens. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, you wonder about that, because they can do that. They on certain buildings and constructions. They can put that into our brains. They can put that into our brains. Like a code, like we see all of a sudden, certain things again and again and again. Yeah, in repetition, and so there's an association, and it's just like a little wake up, slow wake up in your subconscious that comes out into your conscious mind, and when it comes out into your conscious mind, it becomes almost like a pattern. So they put a pattern into your brain, just by that number existing again and again and again, and so you have an association with that number, with their particular construction. So yeah, it you know, you think about, what is your license plate, or what is your the house number of your of where you live, all of these things, what is the significance, and is there a code, is there some kind of code behind it all that created you into this moment? You know what I'm saying? Like that keeps you in a certain pattern. Is there a code that is pushing you into a certain pattern, just based upon everything, like your telephone number? I mean, are all of these things like wedging you in, wedging you in just a little tighter? And so it's like there, I've known people who are just anti-number, don't want anything to do with a number, and just forget it. No numbers. Let's not have numbers exist. Because in a way, they are a pattern recognition. They're just a pattern recognition that can be supplied information again and again, through media, databases, through our own eyesight, what we see and how we interpret it. And in general, you can interpret things again and again the same way. And so if you have a number, or two or three or whatever, you can just be walking down the path of the puppet, through numerology, And I actually haven't been like a big, like looking into, numerology at all, but it is something that's interesting, isn't it? It is. It's a weirdo. It's a weirdo that just hangs out there on the side of your car and makes you wonder, well, if you have a car. Yeah, so it hangs out there on the side of the car. Yeah. And even strangenesses, like why did they pick this zip code in this area, or why did they pick these particular area codes for the telephone? Why these area codes for these phones? And does it change the people overall? In their life, does it change who they are significantly? To always be saying they're 214 or 917. You know what I'm saying? The in this type of a an area code type of a deal. Gosh dang it! I think my phone is going out tomorrow or the next day. So my cute little Android. This is my Android update. I don't have telephone access any longer. So sorry about that, everyone. Gosh, gosh. So I only have email. You all have to email me if you want to get through. And that's the way it goes. Yeah, I am. What do you call it? I don't know. Yeah. They wants like $25 or something, and so I can't give them $25. So I'm gonna not have that That pleasure of it. I guess I can still learn all of the little applications and all of that, and maybe even try. Oh, I can use the Wi-Fi part of it, I believe, but I'll find out. I'll find out tomorrow and let you know, or the next day when it goes out. That'll be interesting. We'll see if I still get Wi-Fi access. Just to download a few applications. That would be so I can use it like a little computer. Yeah, but not a telephone. No, it won't be that. So yeah, that'll be really neat if it's a miniature, a little miniature computer. 'Cause I don't think that's been clear. I don't think that's been clarified by people. So this is kind of a weirdo one. I know. I'm just really excited about joining my little Reiki group. So yeah. Oh gosh, it's fun. It's fun already, you know what I mean? It's fun already, and it already provoked me this morning. I was like, uh-oh. It's not an uh-oh. I take it back. It was almost like I was driven. I was driven, and I was like down on the floor, and I was stretching and getting. Oh, my muscles have been really tight and stiff lately, since I did the little geisha thing, movements, and so I've been stretching my legs out, and it feels so good. It feels so good. So yeah, I did that, and I think this is in conjunction with just joining the meetup group, even though I haven't met anybody from it. Congratulations, because you've already given me what do you call it? A boost. All right. Oh yeah, happy vegan Thanksgiving, and I guess it's over. I guess it's over. So now it's on to Christmas, and I applied for a job at one of those major department stores. And but it's so major that I've never even been to it, because it's one from the south. It's a typical one from the south. And so being from California, I know nothing about it. I've never even stepped foot in it. So I'm kind of interested and intrigued by it. And so we'll see exactly just how much they read from my application and want me or not. And yeah, it's an easy enough I can take the bus there. Yeah, I can take the bus there. So it would work. It would work. Yeah, it's really brightly lit though. The department store is really brightly lit. And so if I was vice president, because I don't really want to be president of the company, but if I was vice president of the company, I would say, could you just tone it down just a little bit, especially in the areas of women and makeup? Oh, yeah. I mean, sometimes, you're walking in there and it's just so bright that, I don't know, it's too sterile. It's too sterile. And women don't always look great with really, really bright makeup, bright makeup lights. So vice president of the company here is already giving you that little update correction. So yeah. All right. Thank you.